Hi, in this video we're gonna use multi-file sketch technique in Arduino. We're gonna use HCSR04 ultrasound distance and a mini infrared peer motion sensor in LED, the Arduino LCD keypad shield, and temperature sensor TMP36. Please visit my GitHub j3@geojrarduserie repository and look for 45 prefix, which means ArduSerie number 45. We have published 6 codes for this lab. Good. Now let's review where we start off. We're just reading on LCD what button we just press it. We define variables used by the panels and buttons, and depending on which button was pushed, we perform an action: right, up, down, select, and none of the buttons. Here is the connection for HC trigger goes 11, echo goes on 12. For LCD data bus D4, D7, for peer goes on pin 2, TMP36 go on pin analog 1. And for LED goes on pin 13. In order to facilitate the connection, before putting the shield, distribute pins on peer and TMP36 on the power bus and connect the shield D2A1. Good. We will connect the trigger of the ultrasound on pin 11, echo on pin 12, see a schema of the LCD keypad shield as well as the power bus. Of this pins, LED goes on pin 13. Good. We're ready. Now we go to the codes. The idea is for each implementation simplify the code using multi-file sketch. Come with us. First code working with multi-file 1. All connections are presented in the comment. See in my GitHub all the comment. And we will run this code and see what results. When we push the buttons on the right side, we have a distance measured by the ultrasound. Let me put my hand position. Okay, the measurements are being sent to the LCD. Great. For now, as the peer, if someone passes in front of the sensor, we have LED on LCD display indicating that the movement has been detected. Let's wait for the sensor to discharge. Release the LED. Good. Motion ended. Now let's check the temperature sent by TMP36. Oops, wrong connection, sorry. Minus 40 degrees. Ooh, it's cold over here, huh? Now let's go to the second code. All the same. The differences? Let's create a new HC SR class. Declare the variable, private and public method, and a pointing object for the class. We call it HC. Exactly here, what that we trigger our object. See? Let's run the code and see if everything is working like the previous code. Let's manipulate the buttons. Okay. Everything looks fine. Yeah, everything looks fine. Now, the third code. Now there are two classes, HC and PeerPoint8. Do not forget to save the classes with the extension .h. See the position that we have been inserted the calls for to the HC in peer classes. Let's run the code and see if everything looks right. All right. The last code, the 3HC peer and TMP36 classes. See the inclusions. See how clean this main code is now. When I press the selected key, I send this by message. Good. Let's run this code. Yeah. Everything looks right. I hope you now know how to improve your coding techniques in Arduino. If you enjoyed this video, please let me know. I would appreciate your feedback on the content and suggestion for improvement. This is your host, J3. Thank you.